Behold, the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent.
Everybody,
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church say
amen.
Yeah.
Greetings, my beloved. This is Pastor Alexander McBride coming to you from the First African Baptist Church, located at 601 U Street in downtown Houston, behind the FMS Chocolate Tree. And during this Lord's Day on August the 2nd, in the year of our Lord 2020, I invite you, you and you, if you are children of God, if Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, I invite you to join us even now this Sunday to partake of what is traditionally called the Lord's Supper or Communion. And it is one of the oldest books, other than the original manuscripts of Scripture, the dedicated tells us how to conduct the Lord's Supper, and that usually it recalls a call of fast the day prior, but here we are even now in the performance of it. And in this Lord's Supper, I just want to give a quick little overview of what the communion of the Lord's Supper is all about. Back during the time when Israel had went into the land of Egypt because of famine, they went in as a tribe of 12. And as they went in as a tribe of 12, their brother Joseph was there and gave them the land of Goshen under the auspices of Pharaoh, where they prospered and flourished until the children of Israel's people became more numerous than the people of Egypt, and they feared, so they brought them under bondage and slavery and servitude. And as a harsh taskmaster for over 400 years, they put the children of Israel in bondage. And they numbered about 2.5 million at the time. And then God raised up a leader by the name of Moses, who means called out of the water. Moses went to Pharaoh and mandated from Pharaoh, after God had instructed him, to let my people go. And as Pharaoh refused, God sent plagues and trials upon Pharaoh until Pharaoh was broken. And he was broken by the last tribe of the firstborn would be taken, whose life would be taken. And the consequences of that caused Pharaoh to let Israel go. Now, in dealing with the Passover was God mandating the children of Israel to take a lamb, an unblemished lamb, to slaughter and take the blood of the hyssop plant and place that blood over the doorposts and the lintels, both sides of the doorposts. And we see in the Old Testament formation of that, that forms the cross. Amen. And by that blood, the death angel, when he came that night to take the firstborn of all the male children out of the land of Egypt, and the death angel, who I believe was a form or typos of Christ, when that death angel came and saw the blood, he passed over the house that the blood was on the lintel and doorpost. Now let's fast forward hundreds of years later, as Jesus Christ was in the upper room with his disciples. He was there and he was partaking of the traditional Passover. And unbeknownst to the disciples, this would be the last Passover. This Passover would now be delegated, transformed, and renamed as the Lord's Supper. And we call it the sacraments, we call it communion. And what Jesus said, I read from you directly from what Paul received, I believe, when he was on the backside of the Syrian desert. I read from you out of 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, and we'll start at the 17th verse. And this is the whole story of how the Passover got changed to the Lord's Supper. And God gave it to us, to them, to us, to continue to follow after it from the time that he gave it until he comes back in remembrance of his death, giving us something tangible to hold on to, something tangible to believe in until he returns. So like the ark that was given to Noah, amen? And Noah preached for 120 years that rain is gonna come. We preach through the communion, we preach through our services that Jesus is coming back again. And just like it says in the Bible, up until the days of Noah, where they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, they did so until the time that the rain came. And people are going to do what people want to do until Jesus come back again. So here we go in 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, starting at the 17th verse. Read along with me, please. Now, in this that I declare unto you, this is Paul talking, I praise you not that you come together, not for the better, but for the worse. He's talking to the Corinthians in their usurpation and misinformation in how to do the Lord's Supper. First of all, when you come together in the church, this is what makes the Lord's Supper not the Lord's Supper. I hear that there are divisions among you. And Paul said, I partly believe, but there must also be heresies among you, that they which are approved may be made manifest among you. That's what causes church divisions. False teachers come in. False doctrine come in. Then people side one or the other. And when the church is split, either the good stay and the bad leave, or the bad stay and the good leave, God allows that to purify the church. So everything that God does, He does with a purpose. Even when we think it's bad, God meant it for good. Amen? So, when you come together, therefore, in one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper, he said to the Corinthians. For in eating, everyone taketh before others his own supper, and one is hungry, and another is drunken. The wine was fermented at the supper. There was plenty of food there, unlike what we do with just the wafer and wine. Now, they had a sit-down meal or a lay-down meal, and those that had ate first, the rich, and they drunk all the wine, so when the poor came in after work, there was nothing to eat or drink. And some was laying at the altar drunk, even in the house of God. And Paul incredulously said, what? Verse 22, what? Have you not houses to eat and drink in? Or despise ye the church of God, and shame them which have not? What shall I say to you? Shall I praise you in this? I praise you not. Now he goes into what the Lord's Supper is about. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. God told him directly this, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, while he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it, do so in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whoso shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. What does it mean to eat and drink unworthily? It doesn't mean that we are sinless. It doesn't mean that we don't stumble and fall. This is talking about the attitude in which we partake the Lord's Supper with. If you are in the church and you have an attitude of selfishness, you have an attitude of division, you have an attitude of greed, you have an attitude of lying, whatever that attitude may be, search yourself. This is what he said in verse 28. Let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not understanding the Lord's body. And that's why there are many weak and sick among you, and many die. If we judge ourselves, then we will not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the word. Wherefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, wait one for the other. Amen? So, an overall understanding of this is we are to partake together of the Lord's Supper. After our tradition, we do the wafer and we do the wine, and we do so together in unison. And we do this with a mind that is set and free from motives and impure thoughts as much as possible. So with that said, my beloved, in our tradition, let us examine ourselves As we do so, we pray. Father, we thank you for this moment that you've allowed us, this momentous occasion where we may look back over the years and remember your death and your resurrection, Lord God. We thank you for the tangible things that you've given us to remember this death, burial, and resurrection. And in so doing, Lord, remember us, cleanse us. This is your supper, not our supper. This is your table, not our table. And Lord, only you have the power to cleanse us. So with a pure mind and a pure heart as much as possible, cleanse us, O Lord, and make us what you have us to be. We pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now for the actual ceremony of the sacrament. And to reiterate what Paul says, he says this: For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which was broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Father, we thank you so much for all that you have given us, all that you have provided for us, all that you do to us and through us, O Lord. Even now, as our mind go back to that hill Golgotha on dark Calvary, in the middle of the day when the sun was blackened, we look to you, Lord God, to the hills from which comes our help. Father, we take this and we thank you for this is your body that was broken for us. Take ye, my beloved, eat ye. Break it, eat ye all of you. After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it, do it in remembrance of me. Father, we thank you so much for over 2,020 years ago, your blood streamed down that cross and you cleansed all of our sins and stains. We thank you for that which you provided for us, a way of assurance, a way of salvation, a way of hope. This is your blood, Lord. We do this in remembrance of you. My beloved, take ye, drink ye, all of you. And after they had eaten and drank, they then crossed over the Kidron Brook Valley. But Jesus went into the Mount of Olives, where soon he would be betrayed by one he loved by the name of Judas. So we go also to our Mount of Olives. Be prepared. Watch out for the wiles of the devil. Watch out for those that you love to betray. But most of all, look up and watch out for the return of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So until next time, my beloved, vivet coram Deo, live before the face of God. God bless you.
Be blessed.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church.
To what his word says.
God has spoken.
Let the church
say amen.
Amen. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Make this your response.
Amen.
To whatever he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body.
Amen.